Hi viewer, I welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies form 2, lesson number 9. The topic it is forms of business units. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Lesson objectives. Today we will basically be dealing with types of cooperative societies in Kenya, and then state the advantages and disadvantages of these cooperatives. Also, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to identify the different types of cooperatives in Kenya and also state their advantages and disadvantages. We start by looking at the types of cooperatives, societies in Kenya. Remember, we said according to the activity they do, we have three cooperatives. There is the producer cooperative. We also have consumer cooperatives and saving cooperatives. We start with the first one, that is the producer cooperatives. This is an association of producers who have come together to improve the production and marketing of their products. So their duty is to improve their production, and also when it comes to marketing, they market their products. It serves the following purpose. One, obtaining better prices for their members' product. So that is one work of the producer cooperative. They provide better prices for their members' product. As you can be able to see, those are producers. They are in the farm, but they have made their organization, cooperative organization, where they take their product after they get it from the farm. This cooperative, it is responsible for the marketing of this crop they have grown. So as a result, their duty is only to do the cultivation, then take it to the cooperative. Then the cooperative is responsible for doing the marketing. Not the farmer is going to go to the farm to do the market, is going to go to the market to do the marketing. No, the cooperative they are formed, they are the ones that are responsible for the marketing of their products. Number two, providing better storage facilities for the products. You get that? After the farmer produces the commodity, he might get that he don't have the storage facilities. So the work of the cooperative, it is to ensure that the storage of the commodity that has been produced by the farmers is stored in better places. So their work, it is to offer the storage services until it is ready for the market. Number three, providing better and reliable transport means for moving the product from the source to the market by building feeder roads. So the cooperatives are responsible for doing or for the repairing the feeder roads. They are making the feeder roads. So they ensure that these roads are built, these roads are constructed in order to get the goods to the market at the right time, and also get the raw materials, get the things the farmers need at the right time. Number three, providing services of grading, packaging, and processing of produce to the members. So they do the grading of the product after it gets to the market, they do the packing, they do the processing of the produce to the members, all that. And then they do the marketing. Number next, providing loans to the members. So they are there to advance loans. They advance the members in order for the members to work in a better, to produce the right quality. They offer the loans to the members. Next, providing farm input on credit to the members, like fertilizers. We also have the everything that is required in the farm, fertilizers. We also have the insecticides, all of them. Even the seeds, they are provided by the cooperative. Next, educating members on better on better methods of production through seminars, field trips. In this case, they are responsible for the offering of advisory services. Next, we could take the consumer cooperatives. These are formed by a group of consumers who come together and start up shops from where they can buy goods of better quality much more conveniently. So they are responsible for starting up a shop. Where can we get this commodity that we need, that we commonly use? So we can start a shop where now we can be buying all of us. These societies buy goods directly from the producer. Now when you start that shop, you happen to have the consumer cooperative, they go direct to the producer. Members of the public are allowed to buy from the society. The profit realized is shared among the members in proportion to their purchases. Whatever they purchase, advantages. Sell goods of high quality. That is number one. Number two, sell goods to the members at fair prices. Number three, make more profit by eliminating middlemen. Next, can give credit facilities to the members. Next, can pay interest on capital to the members. Next, sell a variety of goods to the members at a price where they can easily get them. Disadvantages of consumer cooperatives. They face stiff competition from large-scale retailers. Number two, may not afford to employ qualified staff. Number three, majority of their members have low income, so raising the capital is a problem. Next, Kenya, being an agricultural country, produces enough subsistence goods for itself. And consumer shops may be mismanaged. Assignment. Explain the benefit that accrue to member as a result of joining a cooperative society. Number two, explain five problems that farmers encounter when they sell their produce through marketing boards. Reference, get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, third edition. If at all you want to get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. You can also Twitter us. Stay tuned to Edim TV. Thank you.